Morning, Steve Free in Chicago with the Morning Grain Comments. Well, it's Friday, it's the end of the month, and we have a USDA report today, plus over the weekend the two presidents of China and U.S. will meet and try to hammer out some kind of resolution or continue talking about trade issues. It's a big day on Sunday and Monday because we also will start trading July weather. So as far as the USDA numbers are, 11 o'clock, we'll be back with a video to say what the USDA said. But basically, we're looking for record soybean stocks on June 1 and adequate corn and wheat stocks, which is a little negative. Now, right now, the farmer's not selling. Cash basis continues to move higher for corn and beans. We're in the middle of the wheat harvest, and right now it seems like the basis levels there are softening a little bit. But we continue to have a huge premium of Chicago over Kansas City wheat, and most of that has to do with the Chicago wheat not having the deliveries, and also that wheat going into storage, whereas the Kansas City wheat really doesn't have a home to go with exports as low as they are. As far as acres are concerned, we expect corn acres to be down from the USDA's March intentions. The number has probably pretty important as to how the market reacts to it. The average guess would be down maybe 5 to 6 million acres. Some people think it should be more. Beans will be interesting because when the survey was taken, the farmers were probably thinking about switching corn to beans, but now you've seen a pretty steep drop in price relative to corn. So in reality, at the end of the day, final bean acres might be a little bit lower than what farmers said they would do in March. And then as far as the weather is concerned, it still looks like we're going to change from this excessive wet pattern to a pattern that shows the northern third of the country wet and cool, the center third of the country being basically normal rains and normal temps, and then the southern third of the country would be hot and dry. For the most part, this will help wheat harvest and help corn and soybeans grow out of some of their problems. And the market thinks that on Monday you actually could see a slight improvement in the corn crop ratings good to excellent category. No one knows what's going to happen between U.S. and China. Obviously, both countries would like a deal. The problem is that probably no one wants to agree with the concessions they have to make to get to a deal. And so we'll see how that impacts. No deal should be negative to the grains. And finally, as far as money flow is concerned, the funds yesterday, sellers of wheat, corn, beans, meal, and oil. We estimate that going into the month end, they're long 20 wheat, 100 corn, and short 70 to 77 beans. The deliveries, 745 meal, 1711 oil, 790 corn. So those numbers were probably, especially in the corn and meal, higher than expected. There were only 5 bean deliveries, no soft wheat, and 862 spring wheat, and 5 hard wheat. So in general, the deliveries, especially corn and meal, were higher than expected. So for the month, winter wheat's up about 30 cents in Chicago, down 5 cents in Kansas City, up 2 cents in Minneapolis. Corn's up 8 cents, and beans are up 10 cents. For the wheat, for the year, Chicago wheat's up 41 cents, while hard wheat's down 21. Corn is up 64 cents, and beans are up 9 cents. So I think in general, what I think is, as long as the weather is okay, for the next 2 weeks, the market's going to consolidate, maybe work a little bit lower. The key is, what is the weather for the remainder of the summer? And I think that if it's warmer and drier than normal, prices go higher. If it's normal, we probably could see the top in the markets over the last couple of weeks. So a lot of volatility over the weekend with trade issues, USDA's report today, weather, and just where the money flow is going to go versus the summer weather pattern. As always, these are my thoughts, not those of ADM or ADM Invest Services. Have a safe and profitable trading day.